हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम यू ऑल इन ट्यूटोरियल ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक व्हीकल। होप यू आर फाइन एंड सेफ एट होम। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस ऑल अबाउट द बेसिक फंडामेंटल्स ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक व्हीकल। सो आई विल एक्सप्लेन इट विद द हेल्प ऑफ वन पीपीटी एंड सम पिक्चर्स विच वी हैव डन एट मेनी कैंपसेस विद मेनी टीम्स। So friends, let's start it. Suppose we have this kind of frame and a vehicle I have designed here. So where we need to understand what are the things are really very important in electric vehicle. So first of all, suppose this is the front wheels, two front wheels and two rear wheels. This is the side bumpers. And this one is the rear bumper, and this one is front bumper. This is the basically steering wheel, and these two places I have created for the battery mounting. So friends, and here we can mount a motor and a controller, and this is for battery system. So what electric vehicle is? It's a basically the vehicle driven by the electric power source, like with the help of motor and controller and battery also. So how we are selecting the battery, how we are selecting the motors, and what is the exact work of controller, this is what we need to understand very carefully. So you can see here, this is the complete vehicle. We have manufactured it before a year ago or 2 year ago something, and we have also many pictures you can see here of electric vehicles and all. So friends, let's understand first what is the role of motor, what is the role of battery, and what is the role of controller. So suppose I am taking here one battery pack. Suppose this is battery and we are taking one motor here, and to control this motor I am taking one controller here, middle of both. So basically we are getting the power from battery source, and battery we can charge it directly from the electric source, any electric source. So which battery we should prefer, which motor we should prefer, and which controller we should prefer. Suppose this is the, we are getting input from here. Actually indirectly we are getting input from driver's end. Suppose driver is sitting somewhere here, and that is trying to accelerate the vehicle or start the vehicle initially. So what is happening when we are starting it? That means current is starting flow from this battery pack to motor. And how much current exactly motor need at particular time, how much torque is required, that depends upon the how much loading is acting on the motor. So we will start at the basic, what is exactly the weight of the vehicle, and how as per the weight we are selecting the battery and motors. So when we are giving certain input from driver ends, and that it's coming from driver to controller, it's coming from driver to controller. So suppose we are giving three inputs from here, and this controller is giving three outputs also, from here, here and here. So three inputs and three outputs we are getting one time. So one, this is input and this is output. So between that, controller is what? It's a electronic device used for giving input and outputs. So let's understand what is exactly electric vehicle. So try to understand it. What is our objective? Need of electric vehicle in today's world, history, development, classification of the vehicle on the basis of power sources, classification of vehicle on the basis of power source, architecture of electric vehicle components, design and electric automobile vehicle challenges, future scope and research areas. So basically, automobiles which are using electric energy as a power source for the locomotion as classified as electric vehicle, we understood. Here this is one type of electric vehicle is given here in this structure. This is a battery source, this is power converters, and this is brushless motors we are using, that is called basically BLDC. And in effort save to environment, reduce the independent of foreign oil, we want to convert a gasoline powered car into a electric vehicle. Importance of electric vehicle, I think you all are understanding. It's not a difficult. What is the scope and how the vehicles are getting modern since 1821 and in 2000 era, you can easily understand. So what are the vehicle? It's basically conventional type, hybrid type, plug-in hybrid and all hybrid types. We need to understand this part. Architecture of battery electric vehicle. So suppose this our front wheel, this is our rear wheels. Battery charge discharge unit, power electronic converter. Here is electric motor. This is a controller. The battery is connected to controller here, and as driver's input is also connected here. This is electric motor. So how the electric motor is getting energy from the battery source or from the controller, and how it is transferring to the rear wheels or front wheel where it is connected. So electric motor is directly connected to the rear wheels here with the help of chain and sprocket. We need to understand what are the components of electric vehicle. Basically in electric vehicles we have a battery pack, electric motor, motor controller and drive lines. Drive lines is basically sprocket chain and sprocket. Battery pack. How we will define a battery pack? How we will decide which motor is required for your vehicle and which motor is required for your vehicle? We will understand. Now the most important part of this vehicle has started here. Power requirement calculation, electric motor selection, battery pack capacity calculation, electric circuit design, motor controller selection, wire harness selection, accessories selections. These parts are really very important for developing any kind of electric vehicle. So let's first understand how we will calculate the power requirement calculation. How we will understand. Suppose we have a box of 10 kilograms. And we need to carry it from point A to B. So that means it requires certain amount of energy to carry from point A to B. So that we need to calculate what is exactly required, exact amount of energy required. So let's first understand the electric circuit diagram. This is called throttle. This is your motor, this is your controller, this is one fuse, and this is the three batteries here. You can connect n number of batteries, one battery to n number of batteries, depends upon your requirement. If you are running with 36 volt battery, you will prefer 12 volt, 12 volt and 12 volt, three batteries. and this is connected into the series. Batteries are connected into the series, and we already know how we are connecting two batteries, minus two plus, here. One part of this battery is directly connected to your controller, and one end is connected to motor and controller both here. So this is BLDC motor, and this motor is actually working on the basis of H bridge. I hope in basic electronics you have study about the H bridge, how the H bridge is working. So this motor is working on basis of H bridge. So any even requirement of this motor, controller is providing that kind of energy or torque. So we need to understand how we are calculating the power. That means, what are the factors that really resist the motion and that require energy? So first one is, we need to overcome the inertia, we need to overcome the friction at wheels, we need overcome the air drag and some more gradients. So here, let's consider the information of vehicle given. Gross weight including driver is 150 kg and acceleration required is 6 meter per second square. Wheel diameter is 279.4 mm. Gradient I have taken a 0%, and air drag, since it is a low speed vehicle, so I have considered air drag is also approximate 0. So let's try to calculate the power requirement. So what is tractive force? The only force need to overcome is the inertia force, which is acting due to the self weight of the vehicle. Self weight means overall weight of the vehicle including the driver also, because driver is riding that. So we will calculate the tractive force. F is equal to mass into the acceleration. What is the mass? That is the total weight of the vehicle exactly. So if the weight of the vehicle is 150 kg and acceleration is 6, so 150 into 6 is 900 Newton we are getting. And what is the torque? Torque is basically force into the radius. Force we will consider the tractive force, and the radius we will consider the wheel radius here. So tractive force is 900 Newton already we have calculated, and wheel radius is 139.7 × 10⁻³. And here we have calculated it 125.73 Newton meter. And we are considering torque ratio is 12. What is the transmission ratio? Input, the difference in input or output gear geometry. Motor torque required 10.45 Newton meter. How we are calculating this? Just divide total torque divide by transmission ratio. So we will get this amount of torque is required for motor to move ahead. So just this is the torque, this is our transmission ratio. Just divide torque by transmission ratio, you will get the motor torque requirement. So I hope up to this point you have understood. Let's summarize it. First we will calculate the tractive force, which is F is equal to M into A, and 150 multiplied by 6, 900 Newton. Then we have calculated the torque. Torque is tractive force multiplied the wheel radius. So we have put the value here and we got the torque. This is the total torque. So transmission ratio is 12 as per the gear geometry. And so here motor torque requirement is equal to a torque divided by the transmission ratio, and that is 10.475. So we need to understand, if we require 10.4 something torque, so this section is what given the torque. This is the RPM, this is the power or motor velocity in RPM. So if we are taking 1 kilowatt or 1 HP motor, 1 HP motor, kilowatt is 0.75. So what the torque we are getting, maximum 10.5 to 14.2 Newton meter torque maximum it can give. So that means we require 10.45 as per this calculation, 457. So we can get in this amount of torque, we can get into 1 HP motor only. So our motor selection criteria has been confirmed. Transmission selection, how we will select the transmission? So the number of teeth on the gear and pinion, that is what transmission ratio. So we have taken it on 12. And what the things you will consider? Speed range, how much speed is required, accordingly you can select the transmission. Space, how much space is available, accordingly you can select. And application of vehicle. So let's understand how we will select the battery pack. So what is current? Current drawn from a motor at full load. That means what is the power? Power is equal to voltage into current. Suppose we are taking 4 battery sets. So 4 battery sets means one battery is 12 volt ampere, 12 volt. So 12 volt plus 12 volt plus 12 volt plus 12 volt is equal to 48 volt here we are getting. One. So current drawn we already have 48. So current already we understood the power. 750 watt already we have understand this. So current is equal to power by volt, 750 divided by 48, and we are getting 15.62 ampere. That means we need at least 15.62 ampere or 16 ampere current to run the vehicle at least for 1 hour. If we need this amount of torque, we require this amount of torque. So we need at least 15.625 ampere or approximate 16 ampere current. So we will select the battery with minimum current of 16 ampere. That means 12 volt and 16 Ah battery we will select. So we have confirmed up to the battery and motor. So let's understand how we will develop the controller. As the name suggests, controller are meant to control the electric parameters. What are the electric parameters there? One is the power. So we are using switch to on and off the power. Speed of motor. For speed of motor, we are using simply, for speed of motor, we are simply using the throttle pedal. When you will play, it is like similar like to accelerator. When we will, you will press it, your vehicle, your motor is start rotating. That means that will start getting the current and torque as well. And the direction control. Direction control means it is not like a steering. You are controlling the direction of motor either in clockwise or anti-clockwise. So you can set the parameters here to work the motor either it is clockwise direction or anti-clockwise direction. And speed limiter. You can fix a speed limiter in your controller if you required it maximum 40 or you have going to manufacture it for kids. You can fix it on 20 or 15, the maximum speed. So we can use the controller for the purpose of speed limit and cutoff. Cutoff means switches, like we have seen there the fuse. If we are removing the fuse from there, the vehicle will stop automatically. Controller is an electric device which takes input from sensors and human operated switches and give the output accordingly. So speed of motor, how we are controlling the speed of motor? Speed depends upon the how much current you are supplying or how much voltage you are supplying in one time. So you can control the current or voltage in one time. Always keep in your mind, you can control these parameters with the help of resisting the current resisting the voltage entering into the motor only. So here is the sum inputs and outputs of this battery. You can see here. So already it has defined by the manufacturer which port will use for which purpose. You can change if you are going to customize your motor, or you can change if you are going to manufacture the new motor for your new vehicle. So let's summarize it again in very carefully. Let's see. Electric components of battery electric vehicle. So we require power pack, battery pack, electric motor, motor controller and drive line. So we will calculate here power requirement calculation, electric motor selection, battery pack selection and controller design. So this is the what flow chart of this electric vehicle system. We have a motor, we have a controller, we have a pedal, we have a battery, it's a fuse and it's a switches kind of. So we have calculated the here power requirement. For power requirement, which the factors that really require power, that is inertia. Inertia is coming because of self weight of the vehicle and friction at the wheels, air drag and gradients. We have considered this and we have find here gross weight of the including driver is 150 kg and required acceleration required is 6 meter per second square. Wheel diagram is 279.4 mm wheel diameter, gradient 0 and air drag also we have taken 0. So power requirement we have calculated attractive force. Attractive force F is equal to ma, 150 multiplied by 6, it is 900 newton, and torque attractive force multiplied by wheel radius we have got 125.73 newton meter. Transmission ratio, this is the basically the ratio of driver and driven, that means gear and pinion, so we have taken it 12. And so motor torque required, what is total required torque for a motor, 10.47 newton, which we get this torque divide by this transmission ratio, you will get this value. And how we are selecting, that value is we are getting in first row only, so that will that is what we are taking, 1 SP meter, 1 or 750 watt. So here how we are selecting the batteries. Current run from motor at full load, there is a power P is equal to VI and here V is equal to 48. So I will calculate the current is equal to power divided by voltage. So power is 750 divided by 48. So this is 15.625, near about 16 ampere. So for we will select that battery which can produce 16 ampere current in one time and with the help of 12 volt. So we are taking 4 batteries, so 12 into 4 that is 48, and in our real project also we are taking the 20 Ah current battery. And here controller, what is controller exactly doing? Controller is controlling the power, speed of motor, direction of motor, speed limiter and cutoff. So friends, I hope you have understand. For any query you can comment below the video. If you are like it, kindly share with your friends. Okay friends, thank you so much.